Deepak Jasani of HDFC Securities is also joining us on the show this morning. Deepak, thanks very much for taking out the time. You know, this has been considered as a time-bound event, and for growth investors who are ready to oversee the volatility of the markets currently, this is an opportune time to go ahead and invest. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, good morning. A lot will depend on how much the investors are already invested in. So for people who are already fully or near fully invested in equities, I think they could wait for situations to stabilize. But for people who are yet under invested in equities, yeah, this correction may be a good time to start their staggered or SIP buying, either in mutual funds or direct equities.
Indeed, for all the people who've been waiting on the sidelines, you know, waiting for attractive values to come about, this could definitely be an opportunity to make those staggered investments. In terms of individual pockets, Deepak, you know, what's the analysis whether or not any specific sector, according to you, is looking extremely weak right now, or a possibility of a turnaround in any particular sector where there has been some stability and therefore investment is warranted?
Yeah, so basically, whenever such events happen, the first things that happen is these consumers will cut their spending. So whether it is staples to an extent, whether it is durables, auto, etc., whatever is directly impacted by consumer spending will get a hit. But of course, that is a temporary hit, because a lot of it will typically get postponed. So that is why in case we see more attractive levels in the market, then it would be a good opportunity to keep buying such stocks, so that once the virus situation stabilizes, then all the postponed purchases or spending will come into play, and people will start buying what they have postponed in the past. So that will have the first impact on the as far as sectors are concerned.
Deepak Jasani, what's the quantum of retail interest are you seeing in the SBI Cards IPO, and what has been your recommendation to your clients? Have you asked them to subscribe to the issue, considering the market nervousness around the global situation right now?
Yeah, so we are sub-syndicate members, so we are not officially allowed to make any recommendation in the media or directly to our clients. So, but broadly, what we felt was that although the valuations don't look very attractive, the potential in the credit card industry is large enough. Now, valuation-wise, each one will have to take their own call. But as far as the credit card industry's potential and SBI Card's placement in that is concerned, there should not be two doubts about that.
Okay. Well, the pre-open rates have settled and we are likely to start off about 0.5% higher. So Nifty 50 about 48 odd points. Banks yet again likely not to do as well as the Nifty 50 if the pre-open rates are to be believed. The question is, can these rates last? Well, I think time will tell. Now, Deepak Jasani, the two large auto names, Bajaj Auto versus Hero Motor Corp, sharp drops in Bajaj Auto over the last 6 or 7 days. Today it's starting off well. Hero has seen an upgrade today, but it anyways bounced back about 3 or 4% in trade yesterday. Do you like either of these two names and why?
Now, as we discussed earlier, consumer spending could get hit in such circumstances. Two-wheeler market is a very mature market. Penetration levels are typically very high, except in certain rural pockets where due to adverse climatic or food price conditions, the rural incomes could not increase, and that is why there could be a cutback in the spending on two-wheelers. But having said that, now if the rural spending is expected to rise because of the bumper Rabi output, as well as good water levels and provided the monsoon forecast is good, then yes, two-wheelers could come back into fashion. But let us remember that the base is very large. So growing on such a large base in a large percentage will be difficult unless the export markets show a lot of resurrection as far as Bajaj Auto is concerned. But for Hero Honda, I think a large revival in rural spending is required, which currently is not clear whether that will happen or not happen. So we can at best look at some sort of a trading play in these two stocks.
All right. That's the two-wheeler names there. I just want to highlight the currency now is...
I wish I could ask Deepak Jasani about HDFC Bank and the pain there, but we can't. But Deepak, what we can ask you about is over the last two or three days, when you analyzed a bunch of these names, the mid-cap end of the market, where is it that you have conviction to invest in with the presumption that the investor will not get impacted by the short-term volatility and is investing for the next 2-3 years? That one very strong conviction idea.
Yeah, it is very easy to say that he will not get disturbed by the downside volatility. It is very rare that any investor does not get disturbed. But anyway, this Monday we had come out with a report on Narayana Hrudayalaya, where we felt ke, targets of 378 and 435 are possible, mainly because of it has a strong brand equity in healthcare space. There is a ramp up of new hospitals which will drive momentum going forward. Higher occupancy and case mix to drive margins. Return ratios are expected to improve going forward. And we estimate about 11% revenue and 60-odd% PAT growth over the next 2 years. So that is one stock which we are looking at currently.
All right. Do you track the footwear space at all, Deepak? Bata, Relaxo. Relaxo, for one, very strong fundamentals. The growth of the company, though it dipped in quarter three, but the management commentary regarding how they're going to surpass industry growth, clock in a CAGR of 15% versus an industry growth of 12%, that's actually not really helped the stock too much. It's corrected significantly from levels of 810. It's now down to 670.
Yeah, we don't have an active coverage on Relaxo, but I think their business model has been good. The promoter reputation is also quite intact so far, and a lot of funds have a fancy for that stock. So I think this may be one of the better stocks in the consumer space.
All right, maybe just the fact that the stock had been an outperformer. Some profit taking on the counter today as well, down about 1.7% at 685.
Deepak Jasani, that I don't know what kind of coverage do you have in the specialty chemical space, but presuming that you guys do oversee it, that space has gained a lot of traction and is very, very resilient even in the current times. Do you have an earnings assumption for companies which might do well over the course of the next 12 to 24 months on earnings?
Yeah, I think one will have to sort of sift between various categories of specialty chemical companies. There will be some companies which will have a temporary blip because of this China's supply disruption, which will be very temporary for a couple of months or maybe one or two quarters. But I think because of this situation, some solid, well-established old companies which are into which are quite well integrated across the value chain look interesting. So among these two, I think Atul and Aarti Industries stand out as far as, and look interesting from a slightly longer term perspective.
You reckon that the earnings growth of 15-20% CAGR might be possible for both over the medium term?
I should think so.
Okay. As we speak though, viewers, keep in mind the markets are trading in the red now, and 0.25% in the red for the large caps, and the banks are down about 0.5% or thereabouts. HDFC Bank has slid to 1171, and that's a sharp crack in that one too. So that is essentially pulling the Bank Nifty lower. But I must say, stocks like IndusInd Bank too are correcting about 1.78%. So there is pain out there as well. Bajaj Finance at 4428 is in the red, and Reliance Industries, despite the Morgan Stanley note showing optimism, is in the red. In fact, the top, there are only one or two gainers, which is Asian Paints and Bajaj Auto, which are trading higher. Almost everything else is in the red. Now, let me ask you a converse question, Deepak. Where is it that due to this, either virus-led fears or otherwise, do you reckon that earnings could get hit? When this first cases got detected, there was a knee-jerk reaction on a PVR, Inox, Delta Corp, SpiceJet, Phoenix Mills, and today's session too, the exhibition stocks, Inox and PVR, are correcting today. Would you use this weakness to buy, or do you believe that there could be a bit of a prolonged weakness here?
Yeah, so basically over the last year or year and a half, we have seen consumer stocks gaining in valuations quite a bit. The multiplexes have also delivered good results over the last one or two quarters, and that is why they have got re-rated on the upside. Now this coronavirus thing could sort of, if it spreads majorly in India, starts spreading in India, then probably people will keep away from going to the theaters and consuming their F&B products. So there could be a temporary hit on them. Now, if you want to be bullish on multiplex stocks, you will have to take a view on the content which will be displayed at these multiplexes quarter after quarter. So there again, it is a slightly tricky thing to do. So at a particular valuations, I think these stocks could be looked at. But I think one will, we will want them to correct a little more before we look at them from a buying perspective.
Okay, Deepak, we leave it at that. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
My pleasure.
Kausam Dugar of Motilal.